Yo, what is up, y'all? It is Saturday, March 19th, and I am stoked. So for the past couple weeks, I've been monitoring Facebook Marketplace, looking for some bike parts and stuff, and I came across this old NV V5. It's the same size as my race bike and everything. It's a little bit scratched up, but dude, I'm stoked. I'm pretty much gonna get this frame. It should be here next week. I'm gonna sand it, strip it, do all kinds of stuff, and basically we're gonna take this bike and we're gonna restore it. It's gonna go from a cheap Facebook Marketplace find into a pretty sick sprint bike slash backup bike. And yeah, the plan is to take you guys along with it. And you know, you guys get to watch the whole transition, or you guys get to watch the whole journey as it goes from cheap bike to hopefully super bike. So let's go, we can't wait.
Hey guys, it's Wednesday the 23rd. I just got home and looks like we have something.
Now it's not a supercross box, but I have a good feeling there's something good in it. Okay, so here we have the thing we've all been waiting for. Let's get this opened up and then we can talk a little bit more about it. So yeah, this here is a Supercross NV V5. This is the frame I was telling you guys about earlier in the video. But anyways, yeah, found this thing on Facebook Marketplace, and as you can see, it's definitely showing signs of its true age. These cuts are pretty deep. It's pretty much scratched up everywhere. There's dirt in the bottom bracket. I mean, again, it is about a $150 frame. Now, clearly back in the day, this thing would go for a lot more. But yeah, definitely gotten some use out of her. But our plan is we're gonna do some prep work, fresh coat of paint, get this thing looking like it's brand new again.
This frame is like the father to my race frame, which is the RS7. This frame came before. It's still got a lot of the same features. We've got the tapered head tube, threaded bottom bracket, strong rear triangle, 15 mil dropouts. So, I mean, it's got basically everything that my current race frame has. Pretty much the plan with this thing is to get it built up. Well, first, before we get it built up, I'm gonna have to strip all this paint, sand it down. We're gonna give it a fresh coat of paint. Gonna get in some fresh decals, and we're probably gonna even slap some new parts on it. But basically, this is gonna eventually become my sprint bike. I'm gonna put like a 57 rollout, something massive on it, and this will be what I use for when I'm not training on the race bike. So yeah, that's basically gonna do it for this episode. This one, I just wanted to show you guys what I'm doing, what's the project plan and all that. Next step is to peel the decals off and strip all this paint. That's gonna take me days. So luckily for you guys, you're gonna get to see a nice, neat time lapse of this. And yeah, I'll be in the trenches grinding away. But once we get this all stripped down, I'll be sure to record all that for you guys, and we'll keep plugging along. And yeah, hopefully in the next few weeks, I'll have a new looking V5 in the garage. So let's do it. Oh, and one more thing before I go. While I'm spending a quarter of my lifetime sanding this thing down and trying to get it all nice and prepped, let me know in the comments what color you guys think that I should go with. So I've got a set of purple hubs. I'm gonna throw a picture of them up on the screen now. Basically, all the parts from this bike are gonna be going onto this one. All the parts from the picture that you see are gonna be going onto this bike. So purple hubs, probably purple components. But yeah, let me know what color frame and decal I should be going with. I wanna try to polish this frame. If not, I might go with the color purple, but I don't know, I'm still undecided. So maybe you guys can sway me one way or another.